Oh, that's part two. Can't believe how long it's been.
Yeah, now it only let me do half an hour videos. Mysteriously. Once I resetted the phone to factory settings, which I advise you tremendously, you don't have to buy a new phone. Just reset the factory settings and you'll see this should start behaving. It's already like more than 3 years old, this phone. I got it at Costco for $100. And, you know, reset the factory. Yeah, because I had to let go. Like I told you, I had to, if you watch all the videos, if you, yeah, like you're gonna find them. Yeah, I know. I was like, I had to use G tactics, you know what I mean? So we had to, one here, one out. I'm gonna open 3 or 4 more channels. Enough is enough of this shit. I let them go because I knew, I mean, they say you have 2 strikes, 1 more strike. Come on, all the channels, all the damn channels. Natural hunters, just like our men are natural hunters. And like I say, people, you know, you feel so sorry when you go to the zoo. You go to the zoo and you see the lions, the tigers in the cage. They break your heart because you know they're free wild animals, and so are our men. I'm sorry, they're hunters, and monogamy is in unnatural monogamy. Yeah, this squirrel is too much for a kitty cat. If it was my Maxil, that's her name, Maxil, I mean like miracle in Maya. If it was Maxil, she can climb. Well, now she gained a little bit more weight. But when I got her in the house, she was tiny, slim. She was a fierce killing machine. Hey! How are you? Yeah, and she's definitely a mulata, because ocelote is just, you know, one of those fat cats with tiny little legs, with skinny little legs, you know. He's adorable, I love him. But you know, that's, it's weird. I always had mostly like black cats. They're very lean, very like, he gotta be stretching all the time. They're always stretching, you know. I never saw, like David, I never saw him stretch. Even like 2 days before he died of cancer, he was climbing in the sink, drinking water from the sink. It's like, you cannot even compare the original cats to this. He thought it was something. Psst, psst. ¿Cómo estás? He said, get the hell out of here, bitch. I'm hungry. I need me to get me something to drink, to eat. You survived the winter. Congratulations, being out here in the street. That's why I feel guilty, you know, rescuing them and like say like, yeah, maybe they just wanted to live a couple of years in the street free instead of being in my apartment for 25 years. I mean, I know in an apartment, they get to live a long time. They live a long time when you're there in your apartment. But are they happy? I don't know. I mean, I feel like as a human being, I feel like, you know, I should always carry some little cat food or something for them in my handbag. As a human being, what would I like? That's the question that we always ask ourselves. Hola, ¿cómo estás, preciosa? I know you're a girl, and you're gorgeous. Uh-oh, okay, TMI. They're like, they're so innocent and wild. They start like cleaning everywhere. Like, you're like, okay, go to the bedroom or don't do that. Yeah, right? I don't know. It's just, I'm crazy. So I spoke, like I said, with my caseworker, and you know, I told him at the end, so when are you gonna call again, you know? So it's like, you know, just check check on me every 2 weeks. And then we make phone calls together so they don't get fresh with me. I'm like, I'm tired of calling by myself. And then, you know, just having bitches just hanging up the phone on. That's what they do. They're so unprofessional. Especially by my house. You know, you call them like, you know, oh no, we don't do that, or whatever. They hang up. The what? But he called, he said, I'm calling for from the whatever clinic. I want to make commercials. And immediately, I mean, you can see that's a different tone of voice. If I call myself like, you know, yeah, well, whatever, you know. They are, oh my God, this morning there was like, everybody was like, oh my God, blah, 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 blah. Like, Becky's, and it was all Becky's. The ones who pick up the phone, like, you know, they're so kind. As soon as, you know, you're with your caseworker, like, you say, I'm assisting my patient into, or in the, like, you know, I'm a patient navigator, whatever. Immediately, so I don't make calls myself. I know that's kind of like, you know, I don't need more stress right now. If I have them, I know if I didn't have them, if I didn't have them, then I have to do everything by myself. But you know, I don't like to do everything by myself. You know, it's like they get so fucking ratchet. I swear, just because of your voice, and like immediately, oh my God, when I call, freaking internet is fucked up. You know, I've said this many times. It's like, yeah, it's like, if a woman pick up, it's just like, oh yeah, reset it, reset the modem, reset it, like whatever. Like, I did that all that already. You know, like that's all you can do. Like $25 an hour for that. I'm like, come on. You know, it's like, I mean, and if it's a dude, you know, like, you know, whatever, you know, they fix the problem. That's the same thing that happened to Marshall's. It was a woman, store manager, and she was useless. Useless. She didn't take charge. Is that a manager? Like I said, you have to manage your freaking store. Yeah, but, you know, like, people told me already, she's in cahoots with the pickpocketers. You know, that's why she was so nervous. I haven't even called NYPD to find out if they got any lead, you know, if there was any more pickpocketing incidents. They were so, the NYPD was just so obsessed with saying, oh, it did not happen here, it did not happen here, it did not happen here. They don't want their insurance premiums to go up. So that's why they oh my God. I don't know why I got so agitated. But I mean, I don't know why, like, well, whatever, you know. Triggers. Yeah, I'm feeling my chest, like, that's it, you know, like, it's a minefield when it comes to trauma. It can be a sound, it can be a noise, it can be somebody, and you have a panic attack. So what are you talking about? I forgot. I forgot what I said. Oh, like, you know, the YouTube. The YouTube. yeah, they left me alone. You know, they just gave me like a warning. Like, oh, we hear music, whatever. So it's blocked in these countries. Whatever, I don't care if it's blocked in whatever. I just want to like have a way, like I say, it's useful, you know, like, you know, I see some of my videos from like 10, 12 years ago, like, what was I thinking? I'd say like, what the fuck was I thinking? You know, I mean, like, It's good. It's good, like, you know. I mean, I guess if you have friends, if you have a husband, whatever, I guess. I don't know. I mean, not a husband, because a husband is like, sometimes it's just, husbands are not for that. I don't believe it, you know. I mean, like, it's for be like, to be like, confident, like, all the time, whatever, blah, blah, blah. You know, like, no. I don't believe that's, it's mainly protection. Protection. And to make her life easier, less stressful, because as you can see the studies, all these bitches are like working, stressful, they all, you get the fibroids, you get this, you get that, you know, thanks but no thanks, you know, we're not really made for stress like that, you know, to be like on the work, to be like, you know. So, oh, yeah, I remember that. I went into one of, you know, another account I have with Twitter. I never really go to that account. I have it, you know. And you know, I said somebody retweeted me. I was like, wow. And it was an African-American woman. And, you know, like, okay, whatever, like. I'm not in that account, so I don't care, you know. So I forgot what she retweeted about. I don't know. But I saw that she had some retweets from Press TV, which is good, you know, like we need to abandon this propaganda. Imperial propaganda, you know, like we need to watch other medias. Press TV is from Iran. And I scrolled just to see what she got on, and I'm like, and I saw there was a tweet from Dr. Umar Johnson, you know, and, you know, I don't follow African Americans on my English account, because that's just for Africa, you know, it's just for Africa, I want to read about Africa, it's like, I really, the more I learn, the more I know that there's no planet without Africa, you know, really, it's like, we need to learn so much from Africa, from Africans, you know, and true Africans, you know, not them, because now you have to say that, because it's so freaking shameless, you see them like, come on, Africa, come on, you already destroyed the Americas, you know, and they're like, just never enough with these damn crackers, they got Australia, they got Europe, they got, you know, just like more and more, just buying land. They're hoarders. They're land hoarders. They're wealth hoarders. You said like I was watching a seminar today with Noam Chomsky. I'm not a big fan, but you know, he said that Canada bought so many injections. Damn, you should get your attention. I didn't even used to hear them. I was so used to this noise. There's so many planes, and now, how can these airlines survive on this? I guess they double the prices, I guess, I don't know. Yeah, so he said, like, you know, Canada bought more injections than they have citizens, whatever. I'm like, what the hell? It's like, these are freaking hoarders. It's just like, they want to have everything. They want to like, you know, like. So he posted a video. It was this video of these wenches. It's called wenches. There was like 100. I don't know how many. I didn't even see it. I'm like, come on. It's like, I've seen millions of those videos, you know, fighting in the street, naked. Come on. I'm like, are you serious? Like, and Dr. Umar is becoming such a simp. I swear. Like, he went into, to say, like, shame on the brothers who were just taking the video and didn't intervene. Are you serious?
I just, you don't even know your own bitches? Come on, you don't even know that? I'm like, I'm done. I'm done. You got a fork? Oh, I'm done. I mean, like, are you serious? Defending those bitches. I'm like, okay, I'm gonna get blocked again because he blocked me from my other account because people was harassing him because I'm transsexual. I never spoke to the guy. I never, like, you know. I mean, like, but oh shit. Still, I was making sure this shit was still running. I never spoke to the guy. I never, like, you know, like, whatever. I'm trying to be very respectful. You know, I've gone to a couple of his lectures to take video to document it. I'm an oral historian. I love to have those. I'm so proud of having, when he came to the Bronx for the first time. Can you believe it? For the first time. That was like 5 years ago, six, I don't know. And, you know, that video, you know, got thousands of copies. You know, that's good. You know, I mean, it's really lousy because back then they didn't have a tablet that was, so it's mostly the sound. You cannot even see. It's not this tablet I got on 125th Street. Remember that Love? It's good to be called Love. All this refurbished shit. And I got it on credit, but I didn't pay it. They're like, you're still haunting me. Like, oh, we're gonna repossess it. Well, come and repossess your piece of shit. That shit was refurbished. It was a nice tablet, you know, for a little while. And it was like, I think I still have it somewhere because I don't know where to take it to get it recycled. I mean, you can still record sound, I guess, you know. So, yeah, I like to, because I don't like to just like a little segment. Oh, I like all the events, you know, in my channel that have more than 20,000 subscribers. I used to have tons of street festivals, all this shit. They're like, you know, some people, they get to really see what happened. Not just to hear, like, oh, that was like, you know. You know, I have some people that are like, wow, this is a freaking documentary. People used to say, you know, like, you go to like, yeah, that's what I like. I like that. And it was good because, you know, the tablet, you can pause it, you know, and then you can turn it on again. And it was like, you know, I love that stuff. I love that stuff to record because I don't like people to just talk without, you know. And then the mind betrays us too, you know, the mind betrays us too. We start remembering things kind of foggy and stuff. So it's good that it's video. There's a lot of video. I have, you know, African Day. I have the Africa Day. It's Africa Day? The African American Day parades. I have like six of those. From the beginning to the end, all the floats, everybody who was there, you know, why was there. It was like beautiful videos I used to have. I used to edit them. Those I took with a camera. I still have the camera. And so, you know, back then YouTube used to let you stabilize them so they wasn't shaky. It used to let you put color, vibrant colors, you know, and crop it and stuff. Now you cannot do nothing on YouTube. You can only crop it and blur the faces, obviously, because they don't want a lawsuit. So, all that is gone. So, like, whatever, you know. I know, like, probably one day, 100 years from now, that those videos are going to come out. Yeah, I'm glad. I'm glad. I'm hoping that, you know, that material, you know, that survives. People can see, you know, like, I used to have, like, six, seven, you know, for the most honorable Marcus Garvey birthday. You know, I used to have the parade. I used to have the parade, beautiful parade, you know, with the children. And all that is gone. I have one or two in one of the channels. I think I have the one from 2019. There was only five people. Only five people went to like, and it was elderly, couldn't barely walk. I mean, like, come on. Unbelievable. This year there was nothing for the Honorable Malcolm X, you know, anniversary of his death.
There was nothing. I went to 125th Street. There was nothing. I hope they're okay because it was elders who organized it. So I said, you know, let's not sugarcoat shit. Trying to sugarcoat shit, this is like... And I put that video of the tribute. I put a video of the tribute. I don't know if you saw it before, but you're probably still throwing up. It's probably still throwing up. You can have everybody full, you know, but not all the time. Bob Marley said it. You can fool people sometime, but you cannot fool people every time. So I'm really hoping. Well, it's the age of Aquarius. Everything's gonna starting to come out. Everything's starting to come out. The planet is very different after the great conjunction of December 21st. It's like, obviously, you know, like, I mean, they think, and that's what they want. I mean, that's what they're trying to create, a big smoke screen, so they can have the whatever reset. It's the Bretton Woods, you know, people that don't even know us, and they're like, Bretton Woods, and that was 71 years ago. They have this hush hush meeting, you know. I mean, they advertised it, but they didn't say what happened. When they all agreed that the dollar was going to be the world's currency, you know, because everybody was there, you know, it was whatever, bamboozled with the U.S. They thought it was an honorable country. They thought it was going to be, that it was a country, that it was, you know. So everybody put their gold in here because they thought it's like, oh, they're so far away from getting, you know, because they have huge mistake, you know, like, stories that now we have countries, developing countries, they cannot even get medications. They have to buy dollars to buy medication, have to buy dollars to get oil, gasoline, to get gas. Everything you have to get done. So now, like, you know, as I speak, they are having those treaties now. Everything is undercover. Right now, everything is undercover, and so we don't know what's gonna happen because the media is also hush, hush, hush. Everybody say that they're gonna go with cryptocurrency, but I don't trust cryptocurrency because nobody can tell you what the fuck is cryptocurrency. Who control it? Who put the first money? They're like, oh, people, they don't know. We don't know this. This is great. It's like, no. I've taught, you know, I even saw this seminar from the end of last year. I think it was the end of last year. I saw this seminar. These crackers they was talking about. And they were saying, if you cannot hold it, you don't own it. So stop with that freaking BS. We must have paper, at least a plastic card. You have a freaking plastic card. Now people are so stupid that they're like, oh, I have the app. I have the app. Here, like, you know, yeah, that app is gonna disappear. How can people still trust the damn crackers? Unbelievable. I mean, unbelievable. People say, you know, oh, cryptocurrency is great. You instantly, you got it, you know, whatever, like, it's all marketing. That's what they do. You know, all the people who used to say, I'm not getting injected, now they're begging for it. Because it's like, oh, they see all the publicity, they see like, oh, you gotta have it, like if it's a fashion, like if it's like whatever, like. I'm like, okay. We're not gonna have money, so what are we gonna have? Well, we need to go back to the original way, you know, like, I guess. I know I will survive because I'm great at, you know, promoting shit when I want to promote it. I can do that on the blog. I can promise that people that want to hear the truth. They want somebody who sugarcoats shit, that they talk pretty. They talk really pretty, and like they don't say shit. Because everybody's watching their brand. They don't want to tarnish their brand. They don't care about people. They care about their brand. My brand. It's like, oh no, I gotta put it out there, like whatever, you know. I was watching on Saturday this lecture from a Mexican doctor with PhD, whatever, you know. And you know, I told him, like, you know, he was talking about, you know, the, I forgot what it's called. You have to translate it. That's too much for me. But of course, he was Eurocentric. You know, he was mentioning the Greeks. He was mentioning French philosophers. I said, why don't you mention Imhotep? Why don't you mention Imhotep? Because he was black. I mean, everybody, the Greeks and everybody, the French, everybody, they based themselves on him. He was very polite. They read my commentary. And he said he don't have no clue who Imhotep was. And he studied in Europe. He studied in Europe. How can you go study in Europe and, like, you know? But I feel like, and then I thought, it's like, oh, well, he got his friends, his peers. He got a scholarship to go to Europe and study. So now he feels obligated to continue regurgitating freaking propaganda. He's doing a lecture every 2 weeks on, I don't know how to say it, I don't know. In 2 weeks he's gonna come back and he said that he's gonna do one, because this was once on Asia. I say, okay, you want Asia, you know, I have lots of pictures. Why you bring these pictures? You know, I made a video, but he don't have email. You know, these PhDs, they don't have email, they don't have Twitter, they don't have nothing. So it's like very convenient. So, but I put his name, the hashtag. I'm sure he Googled himself, because they Google himself. They search him themselves. So it's like when you put these pictures, the real pictures, not to put the bleached Buddhas, the bleached, you know, all the people that are very, very strategic, like, you know. So, yeah, I don't even know why I'm talking about this. You see ADD, how they go, like, you know, I was into... Well, what time is it? It's like... At least I'm gonna have to go buy a sunblock for my forehead, because that's the only freaking place on my forehead. So... I saw one at TJ Maxx for $5. And it was supposed to be organic and shit, whatever, I don't know. Just, I want something else for hair. This is the area, the only area. Yeah, 56 on Tuesday. 56 on Tuesday. Oh yeah, I was just telling you, my caseworker, he wanted to call me on my birthday. I said, like, don't call me on my birthday. I'm like, I don't know what I'm gonna be doing on my birthday. He said, like, you know, oh, come on, it's just like everything is so good. You taking care of your, like, you say, I told him, I talk to you when you turn 56. I'm not having a crisis or anything, but I just have to reflect on that. You have to, and it fall on a Tuesday, which is my day, you know. Aries, Mars is like, well, in Latin America they say Martes. They don't say Tuesday, obviously. We say Martes. You know, Mars, Tuesday is my day. I was born on Tuesday at 5 a.m. That's what my mom say. I don't even believe her anymore, no. So I was born at 5 a.m. 1965. Yeah, it's been an interesting trip. Let me see if this thing is still recording. I don't think it's still recording. I barely see anything, so the sun. have to have the technology, so it's not so reflective. Oh my god, I almost forgot. You know, this, there was this guy I've been talking. I don't even know if I have time to. Yeah, I want to make a third video on this. So there's this guy from Colombia, you know, Afro-Colombian. Somehow, I don't know, I guess, how he ended up on Telegram. I don't know, but we had conversations on Telegram, so at one point I told him, you know, how integration devastated African-American community. You know, it went from, you know, owning even banks, bus lines, cruise ships, you know, the Black Star liners. We went from, you know, and I told him, like, he got pissed. So you should have your sources, but well, it's in English. Can you read English? I told him, like, come on, you're so incommunicated. There's nothing over there. You know, he just think like, you know, it's just very infuriating because in Latin America, everybody who is like indigenous or, you know, I don't know, let's say Afro-Latin American, I don't know. they all say just want a better jobs, you know, better treatment, better opportunities. Even when they see, I say, look at the statistics. Look at the statistics. The numbers don't lie. I go by the numbers. I don't go by, you know, like this, this, and that. All that will come.